Hello, my students. In this video, we are going to show you how to verify or how to prove trig identity that have multiple fractions with different denominators. So let's begin. So you can just look at this trig identity. We want to prove that the left side equals the right side. So we first of all, we go ahead and pick what side that we will begin or we will start with. So you can see that the left side is more complicated. So we'll start with the left side. So I'm going to go ahead and copy down the left side of our trig identity. And then next up, since these two fractions, they don't have common denominator. So our common denominator indicator will be the product of both denominators. So it would be 1 plus cosine times 1 minus cosine. So that would be our common denominator. So let me go back to each. Let's start with the first fraction. It does have 1 plus cosine. So we just have to multiply by 1 minus cosine to both denominator and the numerator. And then for the second fraction, it does have 1 minus cosine, so we just have to multiply by 1 plus cosine again to both the denominators and the numerators. So next step, now we are going to subtract the two fractions. So when we subtract the two fractions that they have same denominator, we don't subtract the denominator. So we just copy one of them. So we'll copy 1 plus cosine x times 1 minus cosine x. Okay, so now let's go to our numerators. So I'm going to go ahead and take the first numerator, which is psi x times 1 minus cosi x minus psi x times 1 plus cosi x. Okay. So go ahead and make a note right here. What we just did is that we just subtract. So the next step we are going to do is that we are going to simplify. So let's start the numerator. We go ahead and multiply. So that will give us psi of x. And then multiply or distribute the psi x. So that will give us negative psi x cosine x, and then again we will distribute negative psi x, so that will give us minus psi x, and lastly that will give us minus psi x cosine x. Okay, so we're done with the numerator. Now we do the same thing to our denominator. So if you don't remember the special factor, then you're welcome. Just go ahead and just multiply them out loud. So one times 1 is 1. 1 times negative cosine is negative cosine x. Cosine x times 1 is positive cosine x. And cosine x times negative cosine x is negative cosine square of x. Okay. Now we go back and we are go ahead and cross out or cancel out as much as we can. So the psi of x and the negative psi x will be gone for the numerator. For the denominator, negative cosine and positive cosine, I'm going to put right here, simplify. Okay, so now the next step, we're going to go ahead and write out what we have left now. So at the same time, we go ahead and combine the like term. So for our numerator, we'll have, this is the same term because it's exactly the same name, right, the same function. So we combine the coefficient, the number in front. So this is negative 1 combined with negative 1 would be negative 2 psi of x, cosine x. And then for our denominators, we are going to have to use the Pythagorean identities because we have here 1 minus cosine square of x. So we go ahead and just make sure that will give us sine square of x. Okay, so I'm going to have to write a quick note for us right here. Here we simplify the numerator and we also apply the Pythagorean. So we know that sine square x plus cosine square of x equal 1. So now we go ahead and subtract the cosine square from both sides, so sine square of x equal 1 minus cosine square of x. So now that's what we can see right here, that we have 1 minus cosine square of x, that becomes sine square of x. So let's look at the next step. Okay, so now next, we go ahead and factor out the denominator. So we'll copy out the numerator. So negative 2 psi x times cosine x. The denominator, psi square of x, we can write it as psi x times psi x. So what we did this way here, that we just factor the sine square of x at the sine x times sine x. Now next we're going to go ahead and cancel the sine x. So what we have left will be negative cosine x divided by sine x, but now we can go ahead and apply the ratio identity. So that would be cotangent x is the ratio of cosine of x over sine of x. So I'm just writing it that way here so that you can see. Okay, so therefore the negative 2 is stay. But the cosine over sine, we can write as cotangent x. And that's just, we just proved it. So this will be our right hand side. And we are done. So if you go back and check with the right hand side, exactly the same at the right hand side. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.